Hello, everybody. This might be, I don't know, possibly the only demonstration of an Amet Echophone. This is a mid-1890s cylinder phonograph, and it has a very interesting method of operation. This came in today. I had to do a few things to it to make it functional, and it needed more than a few things. So I'm gonna try to hold my iPad as best I can here. I'm using an iPad because my phone doesn't have a little orifice in it for me to play this. So this is a 2-minute cylinder phonograph, and if you look here, it doesn't really have a reproducer per se. It has this metal rod, and on the end of the rod is this is formed into the glass. It's got a little stylus right there. You'll have to forgive the focus of my iPad. I hate it when it tries to autofocus. Maybe if I just keep it still. So it transfers the vertical vibrations down this glass rod, which is spring tensioned. The spring provides the downward force. And right over here is a little peg. So it transfers the vibration to this peg in this board, and inside of this is a small rubber tube, which acts as our sound chamber. And from that tube, there's a little port that goes down to this wooden bead here, and in the side, we can insert a small horn, or in this case, I'm using listening tubes. So looking at the top here, it has a 2-spring governor with a clockwork motor, and we turn it on by turning up the governor speed. It's similar to what you'd see on a Puck phonograph. This had a piece of thread on it, and I switched the thread out for a piece of Dacron, which is more grippy, and I got it up to speed. But I'm gonna put this into a groove, and these tips always break. So you can hear it. Let me speed it up a little bit. And now, a really, really interesting thing we're going to do. I'm going to take the end of the listening tube and put it up to the microphone on the iPad. And let's see if you can listen to this 1890s recording. Hopefully the iPad is using the front microphone, otherwise we won't have to redo this. Can anyone just leave a comment and tell me that they can hear it okay? I'm holding the tube right up to the microphone. There's the end of the listening tube that I put up to the microphone. And yes, this will play. Oh, good. Thank you, Paul. This will play all the way to the end of the record, which not many of them do. But I oiled and greased everything, and the original rubber friction pad had disintegrated. Like everything rubber disintegrates. So I went ahead and replaced it with a leather pad. You see here. Sounds like it's a little off pitch. Let's get another hit here. And there we are. You got to experience an Amet Echophone in all of its ridiculous glory. This is a very strange machine. It is not a Puck player. This is from the 1890s. This is before the puck, many, many years before the puck. So just thought I'd share this. Thank you for watching. If you find one of these, you're going to pay a pretty hefty premium for one. And most of them don't work as well as this one. So thank you. Bye-bye.